Hi, I'm Jasmine Greenaway, and I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. In this video, we're going to take a look at working with generic views and displaying data in Django. Working with generic views makes it easy for you to do common data-related tasks, such as displaying the data or editing the data or even deleting it. So first, we're going to look at an example. So here I have a list of cruise destinations. This is actually called a list view because I'm looking at a large set of data or a list of items in a database. So if I were to select one of these items here, it takes me to a little bit more detailed about that specific item. And this is actually what we call a detailed view. So now I can see a little bit more about the destination. So now let's take a look at what this looks like in the code. So the first thing to be able to implement a generic view is to be able to import it. And that's what I'm doing here on line 4. And then I need to add my destinations or these lists of destinations to the page. And this is how I do it on line 14 to 16. So you'll need three things. You need the actual model that you're working with, and you will need the template, and you'll need the context name. So let me show you where that all is. So here we have all destinations as the model. Remember, this is a list of destinations that we saw on the page. Next, I need the template, and this is essentially the page that will have my data in it. And here I have it as destinations.html. Finally, I need the context object that will be used to locate the model on the page and populate the page with that data. And that's what is going on here for destinations. So keep this in mind, because now we're going to look at the destinations.html page, or that template that I was talking about. So here we are in that template, and here we are looking at the list of destinations. So here we have a little loop here that loops through all the destinations and then displays them on the page. So let's take a look back and see what that looks like again. So here we are with all those cruise destinations on the page. And here is that destinations page that has been implemented as a generic view. So this was our list view. Now let's take a look at what it looks like with a detail page. So first we're gonna go to views.py. And now let's look at the destination detail view class here from line 18 to 21. So here again, we have the template name, destination detail. We have the model, which will be destination. And then the context object name, again, called destination. So now let's take a look at this in the page. And here we have the destination name, the destination's description, the destination name again, as well as any cruises that you can take from that destination. So let's look at this again in the page. So we can see here, again, the title, the description, and then all the cruises in here as well. Now the final piece to be able to see these pages in your project is to remember to register them as URLs here. So here on line 8, I have registered destinations for my list view. And then on line 9, I have added the destination detail view to be able to take the primary key or the ID of the destination to show it on the page.